The real chief is there.
The rival faction of the Acholi chiefs is led by the Atiak Ruot, Apire Richard Santo, who says the current paramount chief, Onen David Achana II, has failed to steer the Acholi chiefdom forward.
By the 15th of October, we will have prepared a draft constitution which they will look at, and by the end of the month, they will then approve that constitution. And by the 15th of December, we'll go into election. And the election is purely to put in a new Lawirwodi.
Ruot Apire Richard Santo and six other chiefs had initially given the Acholi paramount chief 2 weeks from the 20th of June to vacate the Kekal Kwaro Acholi Palace.
It will clearly define the role of Lawirwodi. It will define the role of the second deputy Lawirwodi and the first deputy Lawirwodi, and also define the role of the chiefs in this proposed administration.
The rival chiefs insist that the current paramount chief does not have a guiding constitution. Ruot Onen David Achana II is also accused of illegally selling land that belongs to the Acholi people.
The Lawirwodi take executive powers. Does not exercise any executive powers. Come okay, Ken. Won't come. Full stop.
The fight between the Acholi clan chiefs has intensified in recent weeks. Ruot Onen David Achana II has come out to defend his position with accusation that the rival faction is illegitimate and confused.
Like what, the one of Atiak has a question mark because he's not the chief. The real chief is there, in which I personally participated in his installation in 2002. The one of Pagak, there are two there. So who is the chief there?
The paramount chief blames the seven chiefs that include the Ruot of Atiak Apire Richard Santo, the Ruot of Patiko Collins Mutu Atiko, the Ruot of Labongo Ogenga John Obita, and others of illegally calling for a meeting to oust him.
There are only three things that would warrant the removal of a chief. That is, if the chief has gone mad, if the chief has killed the person, if a chief is someone who likes going out with people's wives. Those are three conditions that can warrant a chief to be removed, and none of which apply in this situation.
He has also suspended the seven chiefs from the Acholi Cultural Institution on the ground that he is the true paramount chief of the Acholi people.
So whatever they are doing out there must stop, because we don't want the confusion that is going on. We have been through a lot as the people of Acholi. What we need now is unity, oneness, calmness, and working together.
However, the paramount chief is encouraging the seven rival chiefs to clean up and return to the Acholi Cultural Institution. I am Joseph Omagor, reporting for the news in Gulu City.